start mixing up the hamburger while I go get some more things out of the car. Okay?
All right. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right. The first dish that we're going to make for our tailgate party, come on down here, is inside-out cheeseburgers. You ever had an inside-out cheeseburger?
I don't know.
Okay. The first thing we need is our 90% lean ground beef. We're going to put that in there. Now, 90%, less grease, less fat, really good. Now, to add to that, Jada, we need 2 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce. There you go. Yeah. Have you ever seen maybe your parents put that onto a steak or some meat? It's used a lot in recipes. Now, Worcestershire sauce is basically made up of vinegar, molasses, different spices, but it always includes anchovies. So now you know. Next, we're going to put in paprika. We need 3 of those there, Nathan.
Okay.
Very good. Okay, now paprika. Do you have any idea where paprika comes from? What's paprika?
Maybe from Africa.
From Africa?
Sounds like it.
Oh, I don't know. They may, yeah. But I tell you what it is, it's basically a red pepper, and it's dried, and then you grind it up, and it becomes paprika. Here, you want to start mixing this up, Jada, getting our ingredients and spices going. And finally, Joey, you're going to add our pepper. What we need down there is 2 of those measurements. That's a 1/2 teaspoon. There goes the pepper. 1 more. And who has an idea about pepper? Where do you think pepper comes from? Nathan?
I don't know.
No? Okay, well, they're peppercorns. And peppercorns grow on a vine, and when they dry, then we grind them up, and they become pepper. Now, time for me to go get the grill fired up, so Regina's back to help you make your patties. See you later.
Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to make patties. I'm going to give you how much meat, which should be about the size of a golf ball, and I want you to flatten it, make it into a ball first, and then flatten it into a patty. Now, each of you have to make 2 patties, because we're making inside-out burgers, right?
Right.
When you get them nice and flat, now round, if you make them in a ball first, okay, you can go like this, this really works well, and then flatten them, they should be nice and round because we have to match 2 together, so they have to have about the same size. And when you get them made, we're gonna put them on this tray so that we can take them over to the grill on something clean. Now smash them out on there a little bit, do you see? Can all of you do that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Good job, good job. Now you have to make another one so we can make inside-out burgers, right?
Yeah.
Important that they're all the same size. And we need to make out of these 2 pounds of meat at least more than 8 burgers.
All right, here's the dairy part. Some delicious cheese to go on. Now we have 3 different kinds. We have low-fat American, low-fat Swiss, and low-fat provolone. So, Jayla, which one do you want?
The provolone.
Provolone, there you go.
Thank you.
Put it on there. Remember, if it doesn't fit, you need to fold it. Nathan?
Oh, some American.
American, okay. And Joey?
I like American too.
You like American too, all right. Well, I'll put Swiss on mine then. How's that? There you go. All right, put them on there. Make sure it fits in the middle because we're going to put a top on this burger with the other patty.
Hi kids! Each time of year is the perfect time to get outside and do some type of physical activity. And when I'm outside on a beautiful day like this, especially if I'm tailgating, I like to throw football. Throwing football is a safe way to get your daily physical activity, and it's a good way to improve your fine motor skills and improve your coordination. But the great news is, even if you don't like football, there's plenty of other sports out there that you can do. And if you like soccer, you can play soccer. And if you like basketball, you can play basketball. And if you like tennis, you can play tennis. So, the next time you're leaving your house, don't forget to pack your favorite sporting ball and go out and have some fun. Go long!
All right, looks like you guys did a great job making your inside-out cheeseburgers. So let's get them on the grill here. Well, just remember, when you're grilling, the important thing to remember is how hot grills can get. You can really burn and get hurt. And we don't want to squish these. Why wouldn't we want to push down on these?
Because, like, it might go through the grill.
Well, that, but we're making inside-out cheeseburgers. We don't want the cheese squirting out, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, very good. Now, we're going to have some hot dogs, too. Remember our healthy hot dogs that we talked about? So I'll change utensils here, and I'll get, these are tongs. Tongs are easy to use because you can grab things and pick them up. So we're going to put on some hot dogs. And to make it even healthier, Jayla, why don't you show me what we have there as far as vegetables? We have some zucchini spears. And what we have on here is a little bit of olive oil, which we know is the good oil, and a little bit of pepper. Okay. And we're going to throw on a few onions. Boy, we love onions on the grill, too. So there you go, guys. All we have to do now is cook everything while you go off now, and your next task is to help out Regina with the salad and the fruit.
Hey, kids, come on over here. We need to get these salads going. Nathan, you are going to peel that cucumber. Do you know how to do that?
Yep.
And then you have to carefully cut it so it goes in the salad into rings. Now, you know you have to be really careful with knives, right?
Yep.
So you can start doing that, Nathan. Now, Jayla, you also are going to be really careful with these, right? You're going to cut this tomato up to go in the salad. Do you know how to do that?
Yeah.
And you're going to cut up some radishes and some carrots and this. And have you seen this lettuce before? It's romaine. Actually, the greener the lettuce, the healthier it is. And you're just going to cut it like this, and it'll be, you can put those things, we'll put all those things right in the bowl, okay? Now, besides what they're making, we're going to add some spinach. It's really green. You can tell it's really healthy. And we're going to add some sunflower seeds and raisins just to the people salads that want it, because those are healthy additions to the salad. You can put any fruit in your salad. Now, Joseph, can I call you Joseph? This is serious, so I should call you Joseph, right? I mean, not Joey and Joseph. Okay, Joseph, we're going to make salad dressing. Okay, you're going to put this cup into here. Go, put it right over the bowl, and this is low-fat sour cream. Okay, get low-fat or no-fat sour cream, and you're going to put about a cup in there. You can turn it upside down. Does that work easier? Oh, here, let me try it this way. How about that?
All right.
There you go. I knew, Joseph, you could do this. Okay, good job. And then you're going to be putting in a cup. This is mayonnaise that's low-fat made with olive oil. Remember that this is about how much salad dressing you should put on your salad. So we don't want to use too much. Now to that, you're going to first mix up a teaspoon of parsley. We're just going to make a small amount. The recipe calls for more. We're going to put it in that bowl, in this bowl first. Some dried onions. Doesn't that look good? And some garlic. Now this is garlic powder, not garlic salt. Just put your spoon in there and take some out. Very good. And a little tiny bit of low sodium salt. Just half or so. Okay, mix those up. Perfect. Now if we were making this, you can then put 2 tablespoons in there. Perfect. Okay, those aren't quite a tablespoon. We're not using an exact measure. We'll put just a little more. Now you mix up that salad dressing, and you two can start putting your stuff in this bowl, okay? Oh, wow, Nate, nice job. Show those cucumbers. Look at how cute those are. All right, everyone, can you put your salad items? I'm going to trade places with you for 1 minute. Will you keep mixing and get that really mixed? All right, I'm going to put some spinach in. And Jayla, can you put the lettuce in? Now, if you look, these are different colors. It's really good to have different color mats, because if you're cutting meat on one, it should be one color. If you're cutting fruit on one, it should be one color, so that we don't mix. And also, so everyone knows, I washed all these vegetables before I brought them. We put the tomatoes in. Very nice. And Nathan, we need those cucumbers and peppers that you're doing so great. All right, I think that we're done here, but you know what else we have to cut up to have a complete food plate? Some fruit. So let's go get the fruit, okay? Now I want you to peel that kiwi and cut it in slices, and get some slices of watermelon to put on our fruit tray. Jayla, you're going to scoop out those seeds over at the garbage can, and then put some slices of cantaloupe on, and you're gonna use those kitchen scissors. Show them the kitchen scissors. They're indispensable kitchen scissors, and you're gonna cut little bunches of grapes and put on there, and decorate it any way you want. Nathan, you're gonna take the tops off these strawberries, cut them in half, and what do you think in the center? There's also some what?
Pineapple,
and you wanna put some pineapple. Okay, and while you guys do all that work, I'm going to sit here and eat grapes, okay? kids, I think we got a beautiful tray there and we need to go and eat. Do you think the food's all cooked on the grill?
Yeah. Yep.
All right, grab that tray and come on, Jayla. Come on, guys, let's go eat. Look at that, Glenn, he's already eating. Get a plate and fill your plates.
Look at all the things that you guys made.
There's fruits, vegetables, and protein. And what is our grain at this meal?
Buns.
The whole grain buns, that's right. And look, I made you a surprise. They're healthy cookies. They have in whole wheat flour, oatmeal, seeds. They're very healthy, and in fact, they're vegan even if you're into that. When you make your lemonade, you can put in 1 teaspoon, which is only 17 calories of sugar, much less than at the fair. Okay, everybody fill their plates and let's eat.
So we want to thank you for joining us for this tailgating episode of Kids Can Cook. And remember, send us in your recipes or send us in pictures of you and your family sharing cooking in your kitchen at home. Once again, we want to thank the Walking Doc for coming out for our tailgate and giving the kids another fitness tip. That was really nice.
And so remember, watch us next week on Kids Can
Cook.
Good kids? You love that zucchini, don't you?
Some cooking and really have a lunch.
1, 2, 3.
Pick it up from like the burger line where you said I'm gonna make some burgers so you can take eat them later and then just put out a bunch.
Oh, of course. We can dance all day long. That's the best part about here. Everyone dances at the butcher shop.
All right, my middle, get back there. My middle son, me child, of science.
Thank you. What do you got for us?
Me.
From where?
Catullo's.
All right, we're going to have Glenn put this over there by the grill. Oops, it's a good thing it's wrapped.
Me.
Yeah? And where'd you get it at?
Catullo's.
That's right, Catullo's. Wasn't he nice?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
There you go, Glenn.
Fumbled the meat.
Just line them up, your hands. Jayla's almost got hers. How are we doing? Nathan's having trouble. Here, Nate. Do you have sweaty hands or what?